Hi there, and welcome back to Sonic Nebulous. When we last left off, we left the Great Jungle. So today, we're going to go into the Temple of Mauga. So, our character for today is going to be... Let's see... Ah, yes! Rosie the Chipmunk. Let's see how an old lady handles against Robotnik's forces. And let's get my mouse off screen here. Alright, so, if you ignore the misspelling on the title card for this place, this is still the Temple of Mauga. I don't know why there's two different spellings on it, but that's alright. So, this here is Rosie the Chipmunk. She's cool because she has a boomerang. Actually, she has two attacks. Besides the boomerang, she has her, let's see, what the hit button is it? There it is. You press right and you hold A, and she'll bring out her walking stick and hit people with it. Now, other than the boomerang and stick, she has one more ability, which is the standard jump on enemies to hurt them. So, with, was it no less than three moves at her disposal so far, she is the most versatile character we actually have right now. The only move she's actually missing is the ability to just do a run dash from a solid position like any of the other Hedgehog type characters we have. Now another fun fact to note is Rosie the Chipmunk does exist in Sad Elm, both the show and the comic series. Her primary role initially before the Freedom Fighters were formed was she was the nanny to Princess Sally. I mean, she's also one of the original survivors of the original Freedom Fighter group that got eradicated by Robotnik Prime, as it were. Since then, well, this game's story pretty much told you what she's done. And that served as a sort of nanny to the other Freedom Fighters, or the Generation 2 types. Come on. So if you noticed, oh wow, those cameras take a picture of us first, at least one or two, and then they decide they want to kill you. They do that by ramming into you. Alright, so let's see, he wants us to go up, right? No? Alright, let's try this way. So these ancient nickel statues, I think, are telling us which way we're supposed to go. In that area right there was supposed to be a bit of precision platforming. You gotta jump past the first set of spikes, then the next set of spikes, landing on the edge, which will give you just enough room to make the jump to the other side. But you still have to avoid the spikes there, too. Now, one thing I really haven't mentioned, I guess, in this... is the, music this game has so far. For what it's worth, it's, not too bad, honestly. Uh-oh. There we go. It kind of fits the aesthetic this game is trying to present, with a more ethereal tone to it. But again, overall, this game is presented much better than its sequel is. It looks a lot better and everything. I guess really my only complaint would have to be... No, dang it. Some of the characters don't seem like they're finished. That's really it. And I really dislike that section there. Alright, give me a moment, we're gonna come back and fix that. Alright, so what you didn't see there was a, there was a wind force that blew us into spikes if we're not quick enough. So I had to avoid it the best I can. You can see it right there, where we just fly up into the air for no reason. Oh. Let me give it a second to get that wind to go by one more time before I make a cross. There it is. Alright. So let's make the jump. Jump! This way. Well, the chimney statue told me to go right. I guess I should. Oh dear. No. Oh. Alright. So, another thing to note with our. Oh, wow. Oh, shoot. Come on, Blue. There you go. Well, give me one. As soon as I get to the safety of land here, we're going to talk about something. Come on, Wind. Oh, crap. Well, I guess it didn't work the way I was hoping it would. I was hoping the wind would give me a little bit lift so I can get up to the upper platforms, but it didn't. Okay, so let's go left. Oh. There's nothing to my left. I really don't like this level's wind mechanic. That's all I'm going to say to that. Alright, so... Nope! Hey, check it out. No. Cut. One moment. Alright, cool. We skipped a lot of stuff. Thank goodness. I wonder what that door opened, honestly. So momentum was my enemy there. Okay, so we're effectively on the other side of this now. So can we get the wind to blow me straight up? She said, no, cut. Oh, one moment. There we go. Pro strats, son. Got it. So what's this way then? I don't want to know, honestly. Just keep going right. Or left, sorry. This thing tells me to go this way, but there's nothing here. So what did I activate? Oh, that, okay. I just came from up here, didn't I? This place is weird. Alright, well, there's gotta be a place down here then. Oh, of course there is. Oh! Really? So there's a wind generator right here. This whole place is a trap. Right, so we're switching to Tails for this because, frankly, he's a lot better for this place. Because I can freaking fly. Which makes this place a whole lot simpler to beat. Jesus. Now, unfortunately, he does have one major weakness. He only has one attack. I assume that's the door I'm supposed to get to. So let's just do this. Hit the button, come back, and do it again. Is there anything over here I can just skip past? No. So we have to go this way. Yeah, this is why I like Tails for this level. Oh, god dang it! Hey, but at least you get a proper introduction to him, right? And how he can make this place his bitch. Or it was punk, I don't know. I just want to get out of here. There's gotta be at least one more route up I haven't taken. There it is. What am I missing for this particular door? I think that's far enough for today, because that level was a pain to get through. So thanks for watching, and join me next time as we continue through the Temple of Mauga.